Purusha. Go ahead.
So the five components of these 11 dimensions, are they anyway related to the panchabhutas, because they seem
No. All five elements are within the, see, that space is different, this space is different. The space in panchabhuta is vyoma. The space in this 11 dimensions akasha.
Okay.
Vyoma is different, akasha is different.
I see. And one more follow-up question. The Dvadasa Jyotirlingas, some of them are supposed to express a certain tattva, like Akasha tattva or Vayu tattva.
No, that is Panchabhuta Lingas.
Oh, so that is also…
Dvadasa Jyotirlinga is different. Panchabhuta Lingas are like a… Trivannamalai is Agni, Kanchipuram is the earth, and Trivanaikaval water, and Kalahasti air, Chidambaram Akash, it means the Vyoma.
Okay. And one personal experience with manifesting power, Swamiji. So when I'm trying to look, I can see that my third eye is activating like anything, but then I'm falling into deep slumber. Nothing seems to be working afterwards.
Maybe a incompletion with the sleep. I'll work on it.
Okay, thank you, Swamiji.
Yes, go ahead.
Yes, Swamiji, we are receiving tremendous alchemy products from you. And can we consider that it will be in the future our micromanagement toolkit? And what?
Sure, I should say, each of the alchemy products, how I gave you the instruction, start using them in the same way. And maybe all the alchemy products, instructions, introductions I gave, we will upload the sessions into the internet so that you can see once more and have an understanding. Surely, these alchemy products will be more and more stabilizing you in Sadashivatva and making you manifest powers.
Thank you.
Yes. And now comes the real products which are getting ready. The grand finale spiritual alchemy products getting ready. With 46 garbha, Mahasadashiva Mandala, and literally enlightenment pill with 11 spiritual alchemy items inside. And the Jnananjana Kantamala.
Tatpalusha, Swamiji.
Go ahead.
Swamiji, it's been an amazing program, Sadashivoham. It's more than what we expected. Despite not enough sleep and all that, it's just been amazing.
No, please, all of you be informed, enough sleep is given. Maybe not as you expect. The needed sleep is given, greeted sleep is denied.
Awesome, Swamiji.
Now actually, if the sleep was denied for 15 days, how can you guys be so healthy? Now answer me. If sleep was denied for 2-3 days and you are healthy, I can handle, I can manage. But you say sleep is denied, and how many days now? It is 16 days. How can you guys be so healthy? Come on, all of you, take a selfie and see the day 1 selfie and day 16 selfie. How bright and alive you are. If 16 days sleep is denied, how your eyes are supposed to be? How your face is supposed to be? But take a selfie and see. How many of you are seeing already your face is glowing? Without makeup. Come on. So I should say that needed sleep is given. See, I'm telling you, even few kundalini shots, few kundalini dosage, you can be without sleep for months, but you are not ready to believe and take the risk. Even 1 or 2 kundalini dosage is enough. 1 month you will not need sleep. Otherwise, I tell you, program like Sadashiva Mandal, sleeping time is waste of time. That's the truth.
So
anyhow, I'll produce few Kutakeshas. Just like how I produce many Niraharis. I'll produce few Kutakeshas, then I'll establish what I'm saying is true. Kutakesha is the signs of no sleep. Again, Sadashiva records in Agama. And this word Kutakesha, Krishna uses in Bhagavad Gita for Arjuna. Arjuna has been given that boon by Pasupata, means Pasupati. Pasupati, Sadashiva, when he gave Pasupata Astra to Arjuna, Arjuna took one more boon of Kutakeshatva. So Sadashiva gives Kutakeshatva to Arjuna. That is why, see, Krishna and Arjuna's conversation, even before Bhagavad Gita, many conversations are recorded. Nowhere he uses the word Kutakesha. Only after the Pasupadastram, tapas, he went and came back, Arjuna, Krishna is using the word Kutakesha for Arjuna. During the Pasupadastra tapas, he got this boon of Kutakeshatva from Sadashiva. Maybe I'll produce you people, then you guys will understand. Yes, go ahead, next.
So Swamiji, it's the program is amazing, and especially all the explanation that you're giving us about the purpose and what should be our life purpose. My question is, Swamiji, for some of us, our spouses are quite connected to you as well, and they are not here in the program. So when we go back, are we going to be in the same plane, or are we going to be here? Because in my case, we work together.
Very tricky. See, one thing I assure you guys, if your spouse is not here, they miss Sadashivoham, or your close family person, somebody whom you really feel they should have been here and they missed, I commit with you guys, next in 2 months satsang, I will reveal all these truths in the satsangs. Tell them to attend the satsang, morning satsang, without missing, next 2 months. So they will be in tune. Not only I will reveal all this, I will also conduct some of these processes. So surely, they will not be, I think the gap will not be too much. Because surely, whatever now I have done inside you guys, you are in a higher plane. It is no question of denying that. I'll do something to help support them also. That's the best thing. Tell them that next 2 months, we will not have any long conversation till you finish Sadashivoham through satsang. I'll have morning Sadashivoham satsangs. Whatever I was sharing here, everything, I'll share. And at least intellectually, there will not be much gap. They will be balanced and they know from where you are operating. They will have a lot of sympathy for the space you are operating from.
Thank you so much, Swamiji. And the alchemic products that you are giving us, that should also help them as well, am I right?
Sure. Sure, it will help them. Because especially spouse means you guys are going to be staying in the same space. Surely it will help. I am also opening up next year next year means 2017. We are going to be having 10 inner awakening in the same hall. Because yantras and garbhas are installed in this hall to awaken the Kundalini Shakti. The same hall we are going to be having. 11 days will be inner awakening, last 10 days will be Sadashivoham process. How I opened Shivoham for the people who already done inner awakening, I'll be opening last 10 days specifically for the people who already done inner awakening, who missed Sadashivoham. All the spiritual alchemy products will be given in that Sadashivoham. I know some of you guys are expecting this.
Swamiji, one more question. The Kundalini awakening, you mentioned that everybody will experience the grace and we will move. There are some of us
still not moved. All right. So let's have the energy session and come. And today maybe we will plan for an energy session. This group I'll attend first. Still you have not had a physical movement. Actually, the impact on the system happens even if there is no physical movement. But sometimes even you need to be confirming that it's happening. Anyhow, I'll attend to this team. We will have an extra energy session. Maybe this team can come first. I'll attend each one of you at least with few seconds and see where that gravity is strong and break that gravity.
Thank you so much.
Satyojata is the first word I heard. Go ahead.
Swamiji, two questions. I'm also in trying to understand the space. So in the 63 Nayanmar story, Pusalar Nayanar, he builds a temple in the mind.
That is a depth.
Depth. And
From the space, he builds in depth. He does not have length breadth. Okay. That is why his temple was more strong than the temple built by a king with a stone and a mud.
Right. Sadashiva attends his temple.
Not only that, after the Kumbhabhishekam, Sadashiva gives the boon to that Pusalar Nayanar, the temple you built will become reality in the physical plane, right. And it is still there in Kanchipuram.
Yes,
see, all of you, I don't know how many of you know this story. See, in Kanchipuram, the temple which was taken out of Pusalar's inner depth and kept out by Sadashiva is still there. You will be surprised. All those pillars and stones does not look like a carved, as if they have been done by some chemical. See, those pillars does not have a chiseling mark. It is done as if they applied some chemical and they made the pillars out of stone. It is still there in Kanchipuram. Still it is in Kanchipuram.
Okay.
Exact the name of the deity. But it is in Kanchipuram. There is a big board. The Pusalar Nayanar Manathye Amaithu Peruman Purathye Eduthu Vaitha Thiru Alayam. Board is there. The temple in Kanchipuram, which Pusalar Nayanar built in his depth. And after accepting that, Sadashiva makes that into reality and keeps it. In the real plane, in the means physical plane. The temple is there. I'll get the name for you.
Okay. My second question, Swamiji, this is a personal experience that I've been having of late. During the Kumbh Mela, I had this experience of seeing the soul. And
seeing the?
Souls. During the long distance,
Seeing
the souls. And of late, in very particular places, I'm getting the same experience. So my question is it like more a delusional thing?
No, it is not delusion. Understand one thing, nothing delusion can happen to you in my presence. When there is a police, rowdies cannot wave their tail. Understand, wag their tail. So when I am there, delusion cannot touch you. Be very clear, be clearly informed. Nothing called delusion can touch you when I am working on you.
Swamiji, I have a boon to ask. Anytime.
See, like in Indian tradition, if you see the Mangal Sutra, you know she is somebody's wife. You can't play games. Same way, the moment you see the Kantamala, delusion knows no, he belongs to Sadashiva. Don't play games with him.
Yes.
And don't go there and get beaten and come.
Swami, my request, I always want to be identified as Swamiji's disciple whenever I have this experience.
Tathastu. Blessings.
Thank you.
Agora.
Agora, Swamiji.
Yes. Satyojata, let me finish.
Swamiji, one question. Is there any correlation between the Trayogunas and the states of consciousness?
I should say, the whole deep sleep is tamas, and dream and jagrat belongs to rajas, turiya and turiyatita belongs to sattva. I should say turiya belongs to sattva, turiyatita not even sattva, it's beyond sattva.
Thank you, Swamiji.
Ahora, yes.
Swamiji, my question is related to the micromanagement. You mentioned that it is nothing but being involved in every aspect of life. So, after attending Sadashivoham, I feel that I can do anything. So, how do I not take up something that maybe I may not be able to fulfill? Like suddenly decide I can be a medical surgeon. How do I keep my whatever I want to manifest? Like,
see, I am telling you. Your will and your ability to manifest will not create conflict in you. If you think there will be conflict, it's imaginary. Will and ability to manifest is one and the same.
Thank you, sir. Swamiji, I have one
Itcha
more.
And jnana and kriya are one and the same.
Thank you, Swamiji. I have one more question. So, since I was a child, I was always accused of not having sthirabuddhi because I always wanted to do everything.
That is not, see, that's a wrong accusation by the family without knowing the context. I tell you, if you are not doing anything, you should be accused as not having sthirabuddhi. If you want to do everything and you made it even 2-3 things happen, you should not be accused as not having sthirabuddhi. Understand? If a child is not doing even one thing, then you should accuse him of not having sthirabuddhi. But if he takes up 100, finishes even 2-3, he should not be called, even if he finishes second one, he should not be called as not having sthirabuddhi. So don't worry about it.
So the pattern of the sthirabuddhi is continuing in the sense that, supposing I'm trying to focus on my work, find a new job, and my wife says, okay, so focus on finding job. So,
come on.
Kind of like trying to prioritize so that, you know, I take up something which I can complete.
See, I am telling you, this idea of prioritizing is another one big mental blockage. I am telling you, pick up Rajesh's book and spend a little time, then pick up the other things. You will see you are able to manage everything. It is actually a knack with all the Sadashivam everything. Talk to your friends who are my Facebook friends. They are getting my blessings and comments and everything as usual. It is actually a knack. See, surely I cannot make a time management calendar for you, but I can tell you one thing. This prioritizing is only a mental pattern. You are capable enough to manage the whole thing. It may look very impractical if you do not approach this idea with sympathy. See, when I heard this truth, I approached it with a lot of sympathy. I have digested it. If you decide not to approach this truth with sympathy, it's up to you. But I tell you, this idea of prioritizing is a stupid mental pattern. You can do everything, always. So jump head over heels. In the initial 1 or 2 days, even if it is a confusion, don't bother. Approach this idea, you can do everything with sympathy.
Satyo
Jata is the word first I heard.
Satyo Jyoto Swamiji.
Yes, go ahead.
Swamiji, I wanted to ask what the method that you use to change reality so effortlessly.
First, what you wanted to do, be clear inside. And give that as a declaration to outside. That's all.
Thank you, Swamiji.